Hi, my name's Dr. Chris Taylor. I'm a research fellow at the Fenner School of Environment and Society at the Australian National University. Along with my colleague, Professor David Lindemeyer, we've published a study looking at the extent of fires burnt across the landscape and the number of times these fires are burning over the past 20 years. Last summer, we had unprecedented bushfires. We saw more than 12 million hectares burnt. And in fact, Australia had the third largest number of fires detected behind the Congo and Russia, and we were in front of the Amazon in terms of the number of fires. In Victoria, we saw 1.5 million hectares burnt over the last summer, and that was on top of 200,000 hectares burnt in the preceding summer. In the last 20 years, we've seen three mega fires. That's three fires that have burnt over a million hectares on each instance. Across East Gippsland, more than half of the areas that were allocated for logging have been burned. So what we found is that some of the most important areas for biodiversity have been burnt significantly. So we actually need to look at the reserve system and protect areas that remain unburned, because these are like arcs that are carrying wildlife into the future. The industry have been operating until very recently as if these fires had never occurred across the landscape. They've kept the same volume of logs coming out of the forest. All the meanwhile, we're seeing more and more of these forests being burned at greater frequency. We have to seriously rethink on how these forests are managed in terms of logging. And logging them under the current way we're doing it is completely unviable and unsustainable. And we're seeing the industry begin to collapse as a result of this, as a result of increasing areas being burned at high frequency, along with past overcutting going back decades. What we're seeing here is evidence of changing climatic patterns. We're seeing warmer temperatures, less rainfall, which is priming the forest to carry these fires at a much greater frequency. Forestry actually needs to catch up and be adaptive, which is currently not. And it can't continue to log these remaining unburnt areas as if things are normal. We're entering a new normal, and we need to manage these ecosystems to be resilient under these new challenges we face.